Not anyone can move you this way.
Trolls World Tour is about a lot of things. First and foremost, it's about music and the power of music.
Music is called the universal language for a reason. It can make you feel just about anything.
But how do we tell that story of the power of music? Well, we tell it through the message of harmony and diversity.
I knew going into the second movie that there was going to be a lot more music, and that was going to be really exciting.
We have so many different genres of music that we needed to have authentic musicians and legends be a part of this cast.
Every time we were able to get someone to come to the studio and pitch the movie to them, they said yes in the room.
Yeah, it was great working with all these different artists and musicians.
You got people like George Clinton, Mary J.
Anderson .Paak, I wanted to meet him anyway.
We had Gustavo Dudamel as Trollsart, Ozzy Osbourne,
Kelly Clarkson, Anthony Ramos.
It's like intimidating in the best way. Like, are you sure you don't want Kelly Clarkson to just sing all the songs?
I gotta go wash what you call music out of my ears.
When you have singers like that, you don't have to do much directing.
I think the great thing about working with Justin on this movie is just the cachet that he brings and the relationships that he has with people in the music industry. Really fun to see how he collaborated.
Justin Timberlake and Ludvig Göransson brought together an incredible team of writers to represent every genre in the most authentic and connective way.
Bringing them early on in the story, pitching them the story, even before we've crafted a full script, and kind of seeing where the songs go. And they started coming up with ideas for songs based on the story we pitched them.
Coming up with all these different styles and bringing them together was a big challenge, but a lot of fun.
One of the most difficult parts of this movie, the most difficult process, was actually to choose what already existing songs to put in.
They wanted to make sure that there was really something for everyone in this movie.
We need to sing them the most important songs in the history of music.
Yes, but which ones?
All of them.
Well, working on Don't Slack, I knew I wanted to make a song with Anderson .Paak for the soundtrack.
The songs like that, they either can take like years to make or just like minutes. And that was one that just happened in minutes.
And that basically came out of a jam session.
And we played it for Justin when he came back and he was like, oh yeah, this is the kind of vibe for the ending credits.
It reminds you that there's no moment like now.
The whole idea with this film was to treat it like a musical and to have the themes of the film really be in the songs themselves.
It comes from our experiences,
our lives,
our culture.
Beautiful.
We took this world that was Trolls 1 and then we expanded it. So everywhere you go now, you realize that there are more trolls. So there's more music, more glitter, more dance, more awesomeness.
But it feels so much bigger than the first film, but with all the heart and emotion still intact.
Music is the truest form of human expression.
There's music every single place we go on this planet. It's the heartbeat that keeps us going.
We create these really powerful memories, and a lot of them have to do with music and how it makes you feel and how it can change your mood.
So I think music is such a thing that everybody can relate to. It's a common language.
When you hear a beat that's smacking and you can't help but to do this, that's something that transcends and everybody can get together on it.
Ultimately, to me, it's a movie about love.
And I think that's what kind of binds us all together, the music that surrounds us. You feel, look, I'm getting emotional about it, really. When I think of my favorite songs, I can't help but cry.
It's all these sounds and all our differences that make the world a richer place. Because you can't harmonize alone.